We have new information tonight about the light plane that crashed near Appin, killing the two men on board. It was an experimental aircraft from the United States, and investigators are now trying to piece together the final moments of the flight.
In charred bushland on the outskirts of southwest Sydney, the remnants of an experimental aircraft. Now a puzzle piece for crash investigators.
Painstaking process for my investigators now to try and piece together what they can from the site, but equally around all of the other factors that were pertinent to this particular flight.
67-year-old pilot Lee Kinneen and his passenger, a Holsworthy man who is still to be identified, died in the crash. Lee was an accountant and landlord from Annandale. He was well known in the community. So too was his love of aviation.
He wanted to be a Qantas pilot, but he didn't have the qualification, so he put himself through college, as far as I know, and got his own licence.
News of his death has rocked the neighbourhood where the father of four lived his whole life.
He's very private, quiet, nice.
We only saw him the other few days ago, and he was all happy.
One report suggests the pair took off from Bankstown Airport around 10 a.m. before flying west to Temora. At 1:15, Lee called his wife, telling her they were flying back and would land at Wedderburn Aerodrome. The plane briefly made it, performing a touch-and-go landing on the runway before flying over the tree line and crashing in bushland in Appin, a short distance away. It's understood the two men had purchased the aircraft together and over the past 18 months had been rebuilding it. After a number of dry runs, yesterday was their first official cross-country flight.
It's what we would refer to as an experimental aircraft. So it had a Subaru engine in it, we understand.
A report into the incident will be finalised in the coming months. James Wilson, Nine News.